Hello everybody and welcome to an incredibly random video that I decided to make out of the blue. Before we start it, I'm going to give you guys a small background. When I was younger and the Pokemon trading card game first came out, like the first base set, it was a thing everyone I knew in real life was doing, so I collected them left and right. But I was one of the few people at the time who actually knew how to play the game. I didn't know anyone else who did, personally. So eventually I just stopped. And for a very long time, I think I stopped before even third gen stuff started coming out in regards to cards. And recently, I don't know why, I really just had the urge to start collecting and maybe even playing the game again, because I've been watching some videos on YouTube and doing some research on the new cards and stuff, and they look pretty cool, and the game sounds pretty fun. So I do have some cards that I've been buying already, but this one I just saw today I wanted to buy, and I thought maybe if I record myself opening it, I'll get really lucky with what's inside. So, yeah. All I've done so far is taken out the plastic, so I thought that would save some time. Alright. Inside is this holographic Samurott card. Looks pretty cool. Oh yeah, and I had the choice between Samurott, Superior, and Embor. I had to go with Samurott, of course, because I honestly don't like the other two. So, by default, he's my favorite starter of the 5th gen. Here's a code I'm going to use online, but the online game is still down after so long. And inside, oh, there's a Samurott figurine. I probably should have read the back. I'm just kidding, I did read the back. I was just pretending to be surprised. I don't think it worked, so I was just admitting that I knew. And he's actually holding his sword. That's pretty cool. I kind of prefer figurines to be neutral, so you can, like, I don't know, that's just my preference. I think figurines should be neutral, not like he's using an attack or something. And here's a little stand for him, I guess. Cool! I have a Samurott figurine. Yay! Hi-ya! Alright, so there are 5 packs in here, yes! There are 2 black and white emerging powers, a black and white, a Call of Legends, and a Edge Chest Triumphant. I'm pretty sure they go in this order if I was gonna open them oldest to newest, and that's what I plan to do. So we'll start off with the Triumphant. Obviously, Heart Gold, Silver stuff was around before black and white stuff, so yeah. Alright, now here is how cool people open these decks. First, take 3 cards, then you put the 2 after in the back. These 2 are guaranteed to be the 2 rarest of the pack, so I want to look at them last. Okay, we have a Carvana, a Shuppet, a Nidoran female, a Tentacool. I hate the Tentacool and Tentacool this set, because it's just a picture of figurine with a picture background. It's really stupid in my opinion. A Dratini. A Piloswine, that's pretty cool. A Indigo Plateau, what the heck does that even do? Each legend in play gets 30 HP. Well, I honestly don't like the whole legend cards concept, so that's never getting used. A Nidorina, holy crap! A Machamp Prime, I think they're called. I think this is like one of the rarest cards of the set, the Prime cards. That's pretty cool. And Magmortar's the other rare. Okay. Magmortar is not that cool, but wow. I've heard a lot about Machamp. He's pretty good. Wow, that was pretty cool. Alright, now we're on the Call of Legends. Now, Call of Legends, I'm pretty sure, is just basically reprints of a bunch of previous sets. So, okay, we're going to take the last 3, put the 2 rarest in the back. Save best for last. Alright, we have us a Slowpoke, a Magmar, a Koffing, oh yeah, a Vulpix, a Bayleaf, a special metal energy. Metal Pokemon suck, so a baby Magby. I know all Magbys are all babies, but the baby Pokemon are unique in this game, because yeah, a reverse holographic Relicanth. Oh, I guess in these days when the reverse holo, the newer reverse holo ones have, like, the symbol of whatever type they are in the holographic. This one doesn't. And the rare is a Tangrowth. I don't think that was that good. But that's okay. The Machamp Prime is still pretty good. So, now we're going to open up the black and white. I haven't opened these in a very long time, so I'm sorry if I'm a noob at opening them. For the record, guys, I have no idea where my original collection is. My parents claim they never got rid of it, but I've searched that house high and low, and it's never been found. So, I think they got rid of it and didn't realize it. And, yeah, okay, in the black and white pack, we have a Blitzel. A Woobat with an incredibly stupid-looking artwork. Okay. A Lillipup. Aww. Lillipup. A Ducklet. A Clink. A Professor Juniper. Professor Oak is better. Alomomola. Vullaby. A reverse holographic Sawsbuck. And an Unpheasant. Okay. I guess that's okay. But. Alright, now we're going to open the first Emerging Powers. This one has Braviary on it. You know it's going to be good because it's about America. Ooh! A code for online, cool. Not that the online game actually works currently, but yeah. All right, a Pidove, a Gothita, a Sandile, a Petalil, Joltik, Lilligant. Oh, I got a Petalil and a Lilligant. That's convenient. Bulldoor, a Drillbur. A reverse Seawaddle. See what I mean? The reverse hollows in the newer ones have, like, see, there's like a leaf there, represent grass. Seawaddle and Swanna. Boo. Okay, that's okay. There's one left. There's still hope. There is still hope for something really good. Well, I'm still happy about the Machamp Prime, so. Maybe that's not that rare. Maybe I'm just a noob, but I thought the Primes were very rare. So, another code. Nice. Alright. Da-da-da. Another Pidove. Yay. Another Gothita. Another Sandile. Another Petalil. Another Jolt. Is this... Okay, Charon. Okay, something different. So far, that pack was an exact copy of the first one. Ferrothorn. Cool. Another Bulldoor. A reverse Panpour. And a Scolipede. Not holographic. Wow, none of the rares were holographic, except for the Prime, unless, I don't even think you count him, because he was in the slot of the reverse holo, not the slot of the rare. So I guess he was really the only great card of this, and Samurott, which was on the cover, so I knew I'd get him. And the other rares I got, which aren't, they're not even that rare, and they're not even holographic, so. These were okay, I guess. I don't know if filming it helped or didn't help.
I know, Uncle Ed. The same cards would have been in there regardless of whether I filmed it or not, but...
I like to make things... I like to believe that... I don't know. If you do certain things, different things will happen. I know that's very vague and broad, but I think some of you know what I mean. Oh, that Samurott is really holographic. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but it's like very, very holographic. There's more shiny lines than in... typical holographic cards, so I think they did that on purpose just because it's a promo card, just to get people to buy it because it's more shiny. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I really didn't know what if you guys would enjoy this or not, so I just did it out of the blue. If you guys liked it, let me know and maybe I'll do more, except I have to convince my wife that I can buy more. And I do that. And let me guys know if I was to do this again, if there was something I should have done differently to make it better, or maybe this was just a stupid idea altogether and I should do some, and I should go back to other stuff. I do have other video ideas, some of them are even recorded now, but yeah, I just thought I'd do this just for the heck of it. So I hope you enjoyed, and of course, rock on!